Now we are going to start with the chemical properties of aldehyde and ketones. So it shows actually many kind of chemical properties. One of them is the nucleophilic reaction, addition reaction. So it shows a reaction like nucleophilic addition reaction without elimination of anything. It shows nucleophilic addition reaction with elimination of water. It shows oxidation also. It shows reduction also. And also it shows many miscellaneous reactions. So we are going to discuss all of them. So first reaction we are starting with this nucleophilic addition reaction. So in this we are going to see that how an addition reaction take place. So first I am going to add an HCN. So this is my aldehyde, right? I am going to add HCN. So we will see that we know that addition occur only when there is a double bond. And as we can see that it contains a double bond because carbonyl group has C double bond O, double bond and then O. So that means we can add any substance to it. But when we are doing it, we have to consider that the carbon tetravalency should not get disturbed. It only means if you want to make bonds of carbon, there should be only 4 bonds, not more than that, because carbon is tetravalent. So when we add HCN to it, it becomes, this whole thing remains same because addition is going to take place here. It becomes O, it's like that, right? And this is also a polar bond. So H gets attached here and CN gets attached here. So this kind of compound is formed, which is called as acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. In the same way, we can add this in ketone. The same thing is going to happen because it also contains a carbonyl group. So again, this is positive, negative, negative and positive because this is polar. So OH and CN. So this is a kind of addition reaction will take place. Second is we are going to add sodium bisulfate to it. So when we add bisulfate to an aldehyde, we'll see that again a similar kind of thing is going to take place. This will remain as such. And here you know that it will attach like this, OH and SO3N. Like initially when we talk of intermediate, you know what actually happens. It forms like that, Na at one place, HSO3 at one place. But then later on this H and Na gets just exchange their places and it forms OH SO3NA. Similarly, in the similar way it does in ketone also. So it remains same and it becomes O, H and SO3N. So this kind of addition product is formed in this case. Next we are going to add Grignard reagent. We know that Grignard reagent is RMGX. So see how the addition is going to take place. This will remain same, this will remain same. Here obviously double bond is present, so addition is going to take place here. So it will form OMGX because this is something like that. And here it will be R. But later on you need to add hydrogen ion. Then what happens? It forms, this remains as such. This H gets add up here, OH, R here, and with that we get MgOHX. This kind of addition reaction will take place. In a similar way here also it will form CCH3 will remain as such. Here it will R will get attached individually and O will get attached to MgX because this is a positive part. And then we are going to add again water which will give hydrogen ion and we will get here R will remain as such. And because we know that water is HOH, so what is going to happen, this OH will combine with this part, NH with this part, so it becomes OH and MgOHX is liberated as such. Like this the reaction is going to take place. Now we are going to add up alcohol. Now when we add up alcohol to this thing aldehyde, in a similar way the reaction is going to take place. It will form CH3H double bond O, so it will be OH and here it will break like this and here we will have OC2H5. Then we are going to the reaction, this is something called as hemiacetal. This is called as hemiacetal. Now to this we add more alcohol and we heat it, right? And when we heat it, you know that what we get here, now we have two molecules of C2H5, OC2H5, and this will be like that. In a similar way, ketone shows an addition reaction, but ketone reacts with dihydric alcohol. It doesn't react with monohydric alcohol. So when we when it reacts in with it, this is something called as hemiacetal. Sorry, acetyl. This is hemiacetal and this is acetyl. And here you know that this reacts with this. This remains as such. It becomes OCH2 and this also becomes OCH2, that is ketal. It will also form a hemiketal, but you can still directly form the this thing ketal, and we are just heating it, the dihydric alcohol, with the ketone. So this is how the addition reaction will take place. I think it's clear. We can add HCN, we can add HCN to an this thing aldehyde as well as ketone. And one more thing you need to remember, in both of the cases the addition reaction take place in a basic medium. We need a basic medium for that. And similarly, we can add NaHCO3, but you need to know that when we add NaHCO3, initially you know what happened, this Na gets attached here and HSO3 part here, then they just this thing change their place and it becomes OH and SO3Na. And when you add RMgX, it forms a compound like this, and then you need to add water. It will take up H ions from the water and it will be attached with H, and Mg will be liberated as MgOHX. In a similar way, we add alcohol. You need to keep in mind that alcohol reacts with aldehyde reacts with monohydric alcohol, but ketone reacts with dihydric alcohol. And what we get here, we get an intermediate hemiacetal, and then we add further more alcohol and heat it, we get it acetyl. And here in this case, when we add this thing dihydric alcohol, we heat it, we get a ketal. So this is something very important and very interesting also. So this is nucleophilic addition reaction. So now we are going to start with another reaction.